We're going to braze steel to stainless steel. We're working with our SSF-6. Now the steel is a little bit thicker, so I'm going to put more of my heat to the steel. And then I'm going to start working in my stainless. We're looking for the metals to turn to a dull red. The SSF-6 is flux coated, so we don't need to dip our rod in flux. We're getting there. We'll put a little bit of flux on here. Just watch your flux. When your flux is active, put one on this side. There we go. You can actually see the flux cleaning the base metal. Just going to add a little bit of rod to the back side of this.
More often than not, many of our customers add more rod than they need when they first start to run the SSF-6. But as you can see, a small amount goes a long way with this rod. We cleaned off the flux with a wire brush and some warm water and gave it a quick polish. The SSF-6 not only looks fantastic and flows great with no pinholes or porosity, the rod is very strong at over 70,000 PSI. The same rod will work on cast iron, copper, brass, chrome moly, bronze, as well as steel and stainless steel. So if you wanted to join cast iron to steel, you can, or any combination of these metals together. It is food grade material, as well as safe in the medical field. When I would go on the road and demonstrate this to maintenance shops across the country, I said run our SSF-6 against the silver solder you're currently using to compare the two. These are just some of the reasons they quickly became our loyal MuggyWeld.com customers. The SSF-6 flows further as 1 inch of rod can flow up to 18 inches. It uses less heat, eliminating warping of the base metal, as well as using less fuel to run the rod. The SSF-6 could work with more metals, including burnt stainless steel. And in the end, the rod just looked nicer and finished stronger than the rod they were using. This is why, after all these years, they are still MuggyWeld.com loyal customers.